So let's recap this. What we want to do is we want to produce, let's just say we want to produce some price data, right? And we want to produce, say, 100 time steps. Yeah. And we want to produce 1,000 of them. But before we do this, let's do a lot smaller. Let's produce price data. And instead of, you know, 1,000 time steps, say, let's just do 10 time steps of 100, or let's say 100 time steps, but only 10 trajectories. Why? Because we can plot them quite easily. Okay. So what we do is basically we just produce some random numbers, and they will be normally distributed, right? You remember, price data are not normally distributed, but this is the first approximation that we use in quantitative finance, that, oh, well, you know, we make an assumption, oh, they could be normally distributed. So what we can do is we can say, well, we want 100 time steps and let's say 10 trajectories. Yeah. So that basically produces a random array. And what we can do is we can just check whether that does what it says on the tin. And so we just produce this random array of 110. Yeah. So if we did like say 10, or let's say we do 5 time steps in 10 trajectories, we can actually just see it here, you know? So we've got array of 5 time steps, 10 different trajectories. So what we could do is now we can plot this. And what we will see is basically just some wiggles on the screen. So what we see here is actually we've got 5 time steps, 10 trajectories. Yeah. And so they don't look particularly impressive, which is what we would expect. Now, as you probably remember, when we, you know, we simulated also something that looks like a price series. Yeah. Do you remember what the extra step was that we needed to do going from normally distributed random numbers to actually producing a price series?
I think it was like the cumulative sum of it.
Correct. Cumulative sum, right? So what we actually need to do is, if we want to turn this into a price series, we need to do a cumulative sum. But we need to do this cumulative sum along an axis. Yeah. If we take a cumulative sum, it'll produce it along what is in this array. You know, it could be rows or could be columns. Okay. So that's what we do here, is we go axis equals 0. So that specifies the axis along which we want the cumulative sum to be drawn. And so you can see here now that you get these cumulative time steps here, basically along this axis. And so that looks a lot more like price series. Now, if we increase the number of time steps, then we see effectively that cone that we've seen before. See that? We've got 10 trajectories with 500 steps each. So it's just basically 10 different random walks with 500 steps. Okay. Now, what's easy to do now is to ramp this up to 100,000, you know. So let's say instead of 500, we want 100. So let's just go down to 100. You know, so that's 100 steps. Now what we can do is instead of 10, let's just say we do 100 different series. Looks like this, 100 series. Now you see, there's this annoying thing in Jupyter notebooks that it you know, it plots the outputs of your function. If we rerun it again with a semicolon at the end, it doesn't do that. So that's, you know, that doesn't give us all this matplotlib stuff. So now we have 100 time steps and 100 samples or 100 price charts or trajectories.